Okay, so I am starting the video before both of my instruments are ready because, I have to be very careful. Melissa's here, but we have agreed that she's going to stop talking during the videos that we do. So I know some of you likes to hear us talk, but some things are personal. And can you please not step on that?
I won't.
And so I'm going to start off with the accordion. And it doesn't take very long to set up compared to the guitar, the electric guitar at least. Just have to unsnap these. And if you saw the last video, I know, like, I run into people in real life. Most of my life is, this is more real than real life, whatever. But I run into people in real life and they're like, oh yeah, I've seen your videos. And I'm like, oh great. And at first I said to them, which one did you see? And they're like, usually the response to that is like, I don't know. But there, I don't know. I think there are people I know in real life who have seen my videos. But my point is, universally, people have not seen all of them. And now that, like, when it was at, like, go ahead. When it was at, like, 300 videos, maybe I could be offended, but I kind of realized, like, at 300, like, no one's gonna watch 300 videos of me. Or if you have, thank you very much. But now my videos are over 1,200, so, like, obviously, if you've seen 1,200 videos of me from start to finish, you either work at Google or I should fear for my life. And I don't know if you can see in the video, but basically I'm playing four buttons in a row. And so, like, usually when you think someone is playing a song, you think they're arranging their fingers in an unusual way to create a musical song. And if they're not doing that, like, I'm thinking back to my days of learning piano, like, so this is the C. Like, that's one of the very first things they teach you when you're like 8 years old. And that tech, I don't know if you would even call that a scale. But that's the, let me look here. So someone helped me out with that. So it goes C, D, E, F. I'm gonna say C, D, E, F, from the sea again. So that's like a fundamental lesson they teach you when you're learning piano. And obviously this is more than just a piano. But anyways, rambling on. So I know the basic notes of the song called Love Song, and on guitar it's like the equivalent of a tongue twister, in that, like, I can show you afterwards, but if I don't know how well the camera and the angle of the camera and the fact that my fingers are blocking what you can see, but when you're playing on guitar, you have to kind of move your hands around in different direction in order to get the right notes. But on the piano, which I'm going to play here, it's actually almost as simple as that C blah blah C B C D whatever. I should memorize it, but it's something that like will come up so often that the memorization will happen naturally in my mind. Anyways, so it's almost as basic as that scale. And the great thing with the accordion, I can press down on the keys like this, and until I move this, there's no sound. So like any other piano, you go like that, you hear a sound. With this, you have to... I'm basically speaking at the level so a three-year-old would comprehend, but I hope you don't mind me being so simplistic, because someone with a PhD would teach someone with a bachelor's, someone with a bachelor's would teach high school, and someone who knows almost nothing about music would speak to their audience as if the audience knew even less than him. You know what I'm saying. And like, yeah. And obviously you can learn from a book, or you can learn from someone on your own level, blah, blah, blah. And there's all these different things. But you're here for the music, and so...
Thank you.
So that's great that there's this very easy song that I can practice. I mean, of course everything is relative. You don't care about what I have to say. I assume you don't care about what the audience doesn't care about what I have to say. They just want to hear the music. Or I don't know why you're listening to this at all. And I'm probably being very discouraging to anyone listening. Just pretend I'm depressed and find entertainment in my depression. So what I'm going to try to do now is to play that same song and also use these buttons here. So yeah, this is not going well. But through experimentation we can find something that works well. Terrible. But that's how you learn, or that's how you learn when you have very little guidance. And that said, I do have a lot of guidance. I have a book specifically designed to teach me to play, and incidentally the book does not cover accordions such as my own, but I'm sure some of it is translatable. So now I'd like to pick up the guitar. And so, I think no one would deny that you have to be delicate with the guitar. I don't think this is like a fragile guitar. I think it can take a beating if it needs to, just like I could take a beating if I need to. Like if you were to follow me into the alley and beat me up for no reason, I could take punch after punch and be knocked to the ground, and people will start kicking me and they call me names and kick me and punch me, and then they take out a knife and they start stabbing me, and I could if I needed to do that, I don't think I need to do that, but if I needed to do that, I could do that. This is very bizarre. I'm gonna... Oh, could you turn on the amp? Thank you. So, I don't know how well you can see my fingers. I think you can... Yeah, you can see the top of the fret. So, this is how you do that. Song I was just playing on the guitar. I guess there's a reason why that pick was over there. Try this again. But notice how on the, if you saw on the accordion, the keys were just like straightforward, down, 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 up, 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 down. I was just, It kind of indicates the song was probably written on the piano. But on the guitar it sounds like this. Sorry, I need to warm up. This is me playing the song. As a lesson video, but seeing how I haven't even mastered it. Anyways, so the bottom string, that's E, and that's called the first string. It's also called the high string, I believe. And the top string is E, and it is called low string or the deep string. I don't know. Anyways, it's the sixth string. Low string is the bottom string is the first string, the top string. Closest to your chin, top string, is your sixth string. So, for some reason, when I... That's usually how I can tell if it's in tune. So, for some reason, I go 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Guess you could do it that way, too. Anyways, so... For A minor, you don't play the sixth string. Then you have an open D, I believe. E, D, I don't know what it is. E, B, D, G, I don't know. It's like the piano thing. I don't know. Anyway, I don't know why I feel compelled to talk. Just notice on the piano I was going ne, 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 ne. And with this I'm going. Then I go down here. And I do this weird thing which is really difficult to transition into. Then I go this, which is super easy. And then I go back to this difficult one. Then this weird one. This is called the G. And the A minor. And then the C, which if you're playing it fast, which I'm trying to learn how to play it fast, like not speed metal fast, but whatever. So this is C major, and C major isn't that hard to to get to, like if you're just starting from nothing and going to C major, like I've practiced long enough that it's easy to do, but if you're going like... Okay, I need a different pick. Okay, I did it well this time, but... The thing is, when you're in the A minor position, you know, my strings are fairly close together, and I think, okay, that's fine. I found it difficult to do that at first, but now. But see, this F shape. If I could zoom in the camera. Okay. I'm gonna stand up and bring this close to you. Thank you for watching, by the way. I know I'm rambling on and on and on. Oops! Okay.
Welcome.
Yes, I'm just trying to get close to the camera.
Is your penis in the shot?
Do you mind if I turn the camera so it can... I might... No, okay. That will make it see you. Okay, I'm going to unplug. Put that down there.
Do you want me to turn it off for a second?
No. Or yes, actually. Okay, so... the view screen. And so I'm stepping over here. This is very difficult. Okay, here we go. So this is F. Like, first you have to bar this. So this is it being barred. Sorry, my fingers are in the way. So that's the idea of the bar. And then that goes there. And then these two go like that. And... And let me try to do it without you specifically looking. Yeah, so I made the right sound there. So that's how you do F. And basically, it is just a tiny bit difficult. Like, difficult in comparison to, say, if we were to do this. This... I hope you can see I'm placing one finger here. Sorry, my hand's in the way. One finger here and one finger here. So it's just those two fingers. I don't know how to do this without making my hands invisible. And I don't know. Anyways, that is E minor. And my point is E minor is a lot easier than F major. So, now I am going to... Did you turn it on?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. What I was planning to do... This is turning into a very long-winded video that has gastrointestinitis. I'm just saying that. And based on the gastrointestinitis, I feel obligated out of a sense of duty to my country, which saved me from the raiders. There was this horrible apocalypse, and so many people. Anyways, so, oh Jesus, I'm gonna try to do this. So the apocalypse took many lives, and all I had was canned food. Oh, I'm knocking over the glue. Maybe I should take the guitar off my body while I'm doing this. But, so plug this in the power. There. Okay. I'm a fearless warrior. I'm sorry I almost hit your head.
It's okay.
So yeah, as a fearless warrior, I am going to go into the guitar. So yeah, now the camera has unlimited power. So yeah, this guy said to me, like, practicing the same chords and scales over and over again does not help, or does not, I don't know what he said. He's like, you're doing this over and over again, and I guess he's watching most of my videos, and I guess if you're watching me practice it over and over again, you're feeling like, oh come on, move on. The thing is, I haven't perfected them. And I think it's just categorically wrong that, like, in my mind, a lot of learning is the, but one of the core aspects of learning is memorization. And I feel like I don't have it memorized yet. And yeah, you know, I could go into stuff about people cramming for SATs and they memorize the SATs and then they forget everything. And theoretically that could happen, but I feel like I'm learning the core elements of guitar, and yeah, based on the core, then you can expand once you master the core or something like that. I don't know. I need sleep. To multitask and entertain you by talking while using the computer. Right now I am looking up the chords of the song I just played. So, okay. So here's the song. 7, 8, 9. So, stupid pick. Okay, 3, 5, 7, 7, 7, 9, 9. So that's E5. Now, go to my chord house, E5. Okay, now what I do here is I open up MS Paint. I guess this is educational. I don't think any of you, maybe some of you do. I'm just trying to think, like, does anyone watch this for educational value, and could it be said to have educational value? I don't know. So this is the first note, and then because Windows 8 won't let me open up two versions of Paint unless I do it a certain way. Okay, so then we go back to Chord Finder, and for the sake of viewing, so that's what I just learned that's E5, and then we go down. So it's 5 and 7. What I'm talking about is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This middle finger is here, but it's not playing anything, and then 7. So let's see what 5 and 7 is. 5, 7, D5. Okay, then we go to, oh man, you know, so, okay, D5, so that's that, and then we print screen, then we go to Paint, then we paste. We go like this. We go like this. I sometimes wonder if I talk with the affectation of a gay man. And I'm not saying that in a derogatory way. What I mean is, do I sometimes sound gay? I think you're allowed to ask yourself that without being like homophobic, right? Are you? Sorry, I'm not supposed to talk to you, but...
I understand what you're saying. It is kind of homophobic, but I also don't think you do.
And so then I go 1 and 2 and 2, so 3 and 5. And that is G5. So G5, there we go, print screen. And we go over here. I mean, if I wanted to get really professional, what I'd do is be recording what's happening on my screen so you could see it. But we live in the land of imagination and lollipops, and you can just imagine what I'm doing. You can just be patient, or you can skip ahead to see the end results. And then we go 5 and 7, but with this, this is actually a power chord. So 5 and 7, A5. And then we go to the piano, A5, and then we print screen, and this is, you're watching the raw, unburdened power of guitar and accordion. Remind me to name this video, the raw and unburdened power of the guitar and accordion. Is my affect flat? I do not know.
Yes.
You're saying it is?
It was, now it's not.
Oh, okay. Okay, sorry. So, scientifically, you could study my mental condition by the fact that my affect was flat while I was multitasking, and you can say the act of multitasking uses up a percentage of my brain, a percentage which is used to modulate the tone of my voice as I speak. And so...
That might be brilliant.
What?
Maybe that's why.
That's why people who are under psychiatric distress...
Because they're busy thinking about all their, you know?
Yeah. I think that may be the case.
Cool.
But it also means I would make a terrible singer-songwriter unless I somehow learned to get past that obstacle, because if I'm spending so much time multitasking with the guitar and also trying to sing, it's a skill that you need to learn how to develop. So I hope my guitar is safe there. It's resting next to my panda. And now I'm taking the accordion back. Oh shit. Okay, good. I'm glad that was not bad. This is why I usually stand up while I play the accordion. But now we have the keys of that riff that I was just playing on the guitar. Is everything okay? Seems like it. Okay. So, we go... Let's start up here. So, there. And... There. so we'll start over here. Between picking up the guitar and playing the accordion, the less you will remember what you just heard. Well, at least that's how it works for me. I said I wouldn't talk too, but can I just ask, did that sound similar to the piano part to the what I just played?
I wasn't really paying attention to that, so I forgot it immediately. Sorry.
Yeah, so I guess that was a failed experiment, because I agree. I cannot hear it either, but nonetheless, let's save this file. And then we close this one, do not save. Okay, and we got a Facebook notification. Someone wrote, okay, you don't know this person, do you?
No.
Okay, I am going to Google.
It means okay.
Oh.
Or like I get it, or like literally I agree.
Okay. And we're at 45 minutes and basically been doing nothing like what we usually do, so let's go to what we usually do. when you're using Vigilante freelance teachers.
Vigilante.
The thing is, like, there are some people who give me advice on the internet, and I suppose this happens in real life too. They offer free advice, and it's like 50% of their advice is actual, like, if you have the idea that there's like an objective right way to do things, or like to go about doing things, like this would apply more to math or whatever. So like say someone tells you 1 + 1 = 2, and then you're like, oh, 1 + 1 = 2. Then they say 5 + 5 = 7. And you say, oh, okay, 5 + 5 = 7. And then you go to the corner store, you're like, here's $7, and you hand them two $5 bills, and they give you $3 change. And you say, well, what's happening? And they say to you, oh, actually 5 + 5 = 10. And we're a business, we respect the law, 5 + 5 = 10. And you say to your teacher, you say, why did you tell me that 5 + 5 = 7? And he said, 1 + 1 = 2. And yes. So that's when these Vigilante freelance teachers, they give you a little bit of like, ooh, that's the real knowledge. And then they say like, aha, but I'm a Vigilante, so I'm gonna teach you some bad knowledge. Yeah. That sounded like the schizophrenic ramblings of a madman.
It's okay, you are a madman.
So after being alone with the computer for 3 years, you've heard its fan, you've heard its hum. There's like a hum of energy from the fan and the computer and the cycles of neurons processing through its internal cybernetic brain.
Computers don't have neurons.
I'm aware of this. So you hear this fan and you hear this hum. And meanwhile, you are interacting, typing things in, or doing whatever you do. And on a very subconscious, like very deep, deep, deep subconscious level, this fan and hum affect how your brain works. And the corporation who manufactured the computer, they are beyond evil. I think if the devil were to walk the earth, he would invent the computer. So the fan and hum affect your subconscious, which affects your thinking. And it begins telling you to do certain things. And I had a punchline, but I forgot. Now I just seem dangerously insane. Yeah. In consciousness.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm gonna look this up. Yeah. It's such a simple song too. This is probably the most basic song I could like ever learn.
Satisfaction is the easiest song ever.
How do you do Satisfaction?
I actually don't remember, but it's like literally one string.
Yeah.
And you go da 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 da. Like you
play
like.
Do you have to do the wah wah pedal?
No. It's a lower string.
Like this one. Are you sure it's one string?
Yes.
The guy who taught me, like he said, this is a correct, he was, I forgot what, there was like some interconnected scales that are supposed to be very long, but he told me this part at least was what he was trying to convey. So this part was, and then I think it's supposed to go further, but I just got this part. He never confirmed or denied if. He never confirmed or denied if that was right.
That sounds cool though.
But, or actually it's. He never said if that was right, but at the very least, by practicing it and practicing how to skip a string.
Yeah. And fingering them.
This just sounds nice.
Why is everything connected to the guitar so dirty?
Okay.
Would you like to practice some fingering?
Or do I want to learn 100 licks?
Yes. Don't break the G string.
Yeah, no, when I went in to get my string repaired, I don't know what I was saying, but at some point, some guy was like, okay, what string did he break? And I don't know if, like, D string, that, if G string's like the girl broke her G string and everyone's like, haha, you broke your, you know, that's the joke, right?
Yeah.
The D string, I think you can make a joke out of that, like, your penis broke,
Yeah, but your penis isn't a string, hopefully.
Yeah. obviously I haven't done all of Caged. But what else am I missing? Okay. So if Satisfaction is like the simplest thing to ever play on guitar, I'll keep it to myself.
Okay, is this the A string? 2-2-2-4-5-5-5-4-2-2.
Sorry,
second.
Can you just suck in from the top?
Yeah.
Okay, 2.
2-2-2-4-5. See? Easiest riff ever.
And then what happens after next?
You just keep playing that, basically. Okay. And then, there are some chords, but
okay.
Like, that's the riff.
Yeah.
That's the first thing I learned, actually.
But it also, like, it has, like, a certain buzz to it, the song, like, in,
I think there's distortion pedals.
Okay. But I'm incredibly tired, and I just completely practiced, like, 100% out of order. Like, somehow I did the root notes, but I didn't do the caged chords.
But you did a lot of stuff.
I'm pretty sure it's over an hour, and a lot of it is me talking.
It's okay, though.
But I'm going to finish the video now, and possibly even sleep. I love you.
Love you.
Whoa.